Dear student, this is question number 34 from SC Verma. So this question I want to teach you how to use the constants. This is the first part of this question. In this question, a pulley, two pulleys are given. One is fixed, one is movable. That's why it is called constant. Now, in the question, it is given 4 kg and this is 5 kg mass. Now, I am just telling you how to use the concept of constants here. If it is velocity upward direction, you know, this is the reference line I am taking here. This is suppose that x1 distance and this is x2. As the length, this portion is L dash, which is over the pulley. Now, length of the pulley, length of the string in a pulley is constant. That's why it is the sum of x1 plus x2 plus L dash. Now differentiate it, it will be 0 is equal to dx1 upon dt plus dx2 upon dt, and L dash is also 0 because differentiation of constant is always 0. Now 0 is equal to this is the velocity of x1, that is b1 with respect to v, that will be, can write it, minus b1, pi minus b1, because when it is going up, displacement decreases, velocity decreases, plus v. Why it is plus v? Because when you take this pulley upward direction, displacement will increase, that will be, that is way we use the sign convention. Now, plus, similarly for the second, where V2 is negative, again V is positive. When you calculate the V, it become V1 plus V2 divided by 2, and for the final relation, 2V is equal to V1 plus V2. This is the shortcut technique you should apply any here in case of the constants. Now this concept I am using on this question. I am just applying, like this is the acceleration A. Now put the tension, this is the tension P. This is the tension P. This is the tension P. And this tension will be 2. This is 5G weight acting downward. Here it is 4G weight acting downward. Like this acceleration is A. You can use 2 points because the point along the string had the same velocity, acceleration, displacement as the pulley here. That's why I am taking 2 points. This is point 1, this is point 2. I can write acceleration A1 plus acceleration A2 is equal to 2AP. I have just differentiated this. This will be 2A is equal to A1 plus A2. This technique you can apply anywhere. Now, when you take point 1, its acceleration is same, just like A, that's what is A, plus A2, it is fixed with this pulley, particular pulley, you can see here, this point 2 is fixed, that's why its acceleration is 0, is equal to 2AP. Now, value of AP, AP means this is the acceleration of this pulley with respect to this, that's why this is A upon 2. This I have applied the constants over here. This acceleration is A upon 2. It will be upward direction because you have taken this acceleration in downward direction. That's why it will be in upward direction A by 2. Now, this is suppose that B block and this is block A. I can write for A using Newton's second law of motion, that will be 4g minus t is equal to 4a Similarly, for block B, 2T minus 5G is equal to 5 into D by 2. Now solve these two equations. It will be multiply this, will support that first equation, and this is second equation. You can multiply first equation by 2, become 8G minus 2T is equal to 8T. Now try to eliminate them, you cancel out, you have 8G minus 5G, that will be 3G. 3G is equal to, here you can take common, that is 5 plus 5 by 2 plus 8. Now you have to solve it. Finally, it will be 3G is equal to, this is acceleration A, and that will be 16, 21 upon 2. Now solve it. Acceleration will be 6G upon 21 A is equal to 2G upon 7. Let's see, A is meant for block A, that's why acceleration of block A is 2G by 7. This is the one part of answer. Now similarly for AB, acceleration of B, let's see here, this acceleration is A by 2, that's why you have to write A by 2. A by 2 means 2G by 7 by 2, that is G upon 7. This is